you do. Nothing impossible, nothing impossible. What can't you do? What won't you do? Nothing impossible with our God. You do not lie, you do not fail. What is hard for you to do? He doesn't exist yet. It's gonna never ever exist for you. You do not lie, you do not fail. What is hard for you to do? He doesn't.
Every satanic manipulation I want to rise against this marriage, Lord, we bring them down. After this, let there be an open door for the man and the woman. In the name of Jesus, let the good things that go with marriage follow your children.
My father is like that. No marriage can separate us. Sister Pacquiao, go in house.
Go marry your mama.
Because the day you decide to marry, you don't tell your papa, say, Baba, you love my father again. Why you know the answer? After today, you dare not answer your father's name. You know, Trayan. You know, if he's still your father, then why are you not treat his name? Your husband is the head of the fathers. So if he did die, give you permission to visit your father, that's the day you will go. If he does not permit you and to stay there, that is what you are going to do today. You have agreed for him to be your head. That is why he's going to pay bribery. He don't give your papa what he need. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Hallelujah, somebody. Trust. Do you know? There are some women, the day you marry them, that's the day your life reverses. Your destiny reverses. Bible said, a man, when you marry, he finds favor in the sight of God. When the man marry, you obtain favor. Because when he that find a way to work, find a good thing, I'll take favor. I told my people, any woman that married the husband and your husband is still in the same position he was before he married you, you are not a wife, you are a murderer. When you marry your husband, if your husband was the one who wanted, you were to join him to go to good, a good thing. A good thing cannot enter the house of a man and a man remains the same. I told my women in church, if your husband is still the way he is, my dear, you are a nobody. You shouldn't be in the house. You enter there to turn his life. So his life should have another. They should see your husband say, before he marries, see how his life is. He not get back. That is why he married. Everything just a walk. That is who a wife is. And you know how it happens? It happens when you are transparent. When you are open. I didn't say don't have your account. You have your account. You have younger ones to take care of. He may not be there all the time to give you, but your husband must know what you bring to the house.
Simple.
You know so. That is trust.
Put it on the table.
Know what is bring to the house. I didn't ask you to give him. A wise man, Pastor David, a wise man does not collect the wife's salary. A wise man does not collect the wife's salary. Listen and listen carefully. If you collect your wife's salary, you will pay times two. It's like a mother collecting money from the child. You say, bring it, let me hold it for you. My son, very big, my chum boy. 18 years old, he got, I borrowed 500 naira. We are driving and I saw something to buy 500 naira. I know we are in church on Sunday, my PA is here celebrating God for her. Hallelujah. When we are in church on Sunday, my office, and he picked money and he asked my PA, give me 500 naira. Mommy took my 500, they gave him. He came back to the house 3 days and he said, Mommy, I had that my 500 naira. Praise God. That I did it to my mother. If my mother collect 1 naira from me, I'll collect 10 naira from her. Praise God, somebody. So any wise man does not collect money from the wife. You don't collect her salary. When she brings the salary, ask her, waiting we go take and do. Even your own, tell her, wait, make she talk up. Wait, when a woman is telling you what to do with your own money, she won't ask you what you don't have. She won't ask you. She will not. Say, well, your money just come. What you want to take and do? Say, no, your money not suggest her. And she see what you take and do. And she go come tell you, say she won't buy you money. She not go tell because she know how you take spender. But when you are trying to be the man, now me be the man, why woman go know what you are again? Until you ask you for Brazilian with God, then you start to cry. Brother, no cry, you didn't tell me what you have. Praise God, somebody. Another thing I'm going to say is that for marriage to be sweet, then you must involve a very aspect of it, which is sex. I have a pastor friend, Apostle Ken. If I refused to marry at the time, I was the one that was helping to construct love tests for woman. Because he's so holy that if they get sending love tests, he's angry. That is the end. So I will carry the phone, I will construct, I will send it. This is what the Lord said. I said, shut up, sit down here. And he got married. 2 days, 3 days, 1 month, he didn't touch the wife. When the wife is coming, he said, I'm praying in tongues. Praise God. He said, if not for the wife, I said in his wedding the other day, if I'm not happy here, praise God, you cannot be born again and not to touch your wife. Say, I'm in the spirit, brother, come to the camera. Marriage is camera. Be camera with your wife. Be camera. Be camera. You know, before you get married, when you are committing fornication, we are angry with you. You are committing sin. Child of God, after marriage, in fact, you are praising God. Anytime you are doing it, you are worshiping God. A pastor of my pastor friend was an Apostle Chris. He said, I agree. He's a son too, with Papa. He had a fasting, and when he was fasting, he said he was on 3 days dry. And one day the wife came and said, honey, this thing. He said, no, I'm in the spirit. 1 day ago, 3 days ago. One day I got to church, he was expecting manifestation. If I was manifesting himself, not the Holy Spirit. He nothing move, and he got on, he said, waiting. This thing where I don't want to do, I get nothing come. My wife come, make her manifest. Now the kingdom of glory coming. When you are fasting, stay away from your wife. Now when you are fasting, 6 o'clock, you pray. Everywhere breaks, brother. And until as you pray, and you say, I want to fast. You know, women, we are very holy. Very holy. When you come to that area, tell your husband, I'm fasting. I want to fast. You know, problem is coming. Let me fast for you. Leave her, not fast for her. Break your heart, break everywhere. Pray so sorry. Because these are the things that we pray, they are irrelevant. And the painful part of it, people don't feel to say it out. They are ashamed to say it out. They are dying on the inside. And these are the important things that are killing the church of today. And the church don't want to talk about it. They don't talk about it. And these are the things we must talk about. Hallelujah, somebody. So that area is very, very important. Before you get married, I wish I meet you kissing. In fact, I will slap you for him. But because you were kissing now, I'm even clapping, I'm even happy and kissing. The same kiss that we are trying to slap, the same kiss was attracting clap. Why? Because you are making legal. Praise God, somebody. And last thing, understand a woman. Understand who a woman is. Sir, I'm a woman. I told my sons, any day you beat your wife in my house, or in your house, I will personally move the wife out of your house. Me, I will move your wife out of your house. The husband is my peer. The wife came and took her. The husband is abroad. And one day they had issue. She always said to her husband, if you touch me, my sister is here, was not a sin. He called me one day, had an issue with his wife. He said, mommy, yes, you said any man that beat his wife, they should take him to sue. I'm ready to go to sue. Praise God, he's here. I told him, I said, if your husband beat you, tell me, we will tie him up and take him to sue.